Today, we are discussing the topic relative density. Relative density. We know that when kerosene and water are taken in the same vessel, kerosene will be always seen floating on water. We know the reason for this, that the density of kerosene is less than that of water. That is why kerosene is floating over water. Now let us fill the table 1.7. Here we have to write examples for liquids of density greater and lower than that of water. Here a table is given, the table 1.7, and we have to fill this. Now, density greater than that of water. Which are the liquids? One is given here, honey. And you can write also sulfuric acid. And another as mercury. And another one glycerin. So, you can write three liquids here in addition to this honey. They are sulfuric acid, mercury and glycerin. Now, what are the liquids having density lower than that of water? One is kerosene, which is given here, and you can also write coconut oil, petrol, spirit, etc. All these have lower density. Let us study more about the density of water and other substances. Density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. That is, it is given. What is the unit of density? Please note that the density has the unit kilogram per meter cube. And water has 1000 kilogram per meter cube density. The densities of other substances are often stated in relation to the density of water. We know that the density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube, and we often state the densities of other substances in comparison with the density of water. Relative density is the term we use for this. Relative density of a substance denotes how many times the density of water is the density of the substance. Then what is relative density? Relative density of a substance denotes how many times the density of water is the density of substance. Kerosene's density is less than that of water. Kerosene's density is less than that of water. That is, it will be less than this 1000 kilogram per meter cube. How many times the density of water is the density of kerosene? How many times the density of water is the density of kerosene? How shall we find it out? For this, we have to find the ratio of the density of kerosene with that of water. How will you find out the relative density of kerosene? For finding the relative density of kerosene, we have to find the ratio between density of kerosene to that of water. This ratio is the relative density of kerosene. This ratio is called the relative density of kerosene. Now, we can define relative density as relative density of a substance is the ratio of the density of the substance to the density of water. The relative density is equal to density of substance divided by the density of water. That is, by dividing the density of the substance with the density of water, that is 1000 kilogram per meter cube, we will get the relative density of any substance. Also, please note that it is a ratio and also the ratio are both involves the units of densities, and hence the relative density has no unit, because kilogram per meter cube divided by kilogram per meter cube will cancel out and it has no unit. Now we have seen that how to find out the relative density of a substance and what is the unit of relative density. That is, remember, relative density has no unit, and relative density can be calculated using the equation density of substance by density of water. By knowing the density of substance, we already know the density of water, that is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Then by knowing the density of substance, any substance, its relative density can easily be found out. Now let us look to this problem. If the density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube and that of kerosene is 810 kilogram per meter cube, what will be the relative density of kerosene? This problem you have to write in your notebook and solve the problem like this. That is, first you have to write the equation for calculating relative density, and it is relative density of what? Of kerosene, because we are given kerosene. Relative density of kerosene is equal to density of kerosene by density of water, and 810 divided by 1000, that is 0.81. We know that division by 1000 is simply arranging the places to 3 decimal places. That is, we have to put the decimal point after 3 places. That is, point after 8, you have to put the decimal point. That is, we get 0.81 as the relative density of kerosene. Now, here are certain devices which we use to find the relative density or to measure the relative density of a liquid. The device is called hydrometer. A hydrometer is a device that is used to measure the relative density of a liquid. Here in figure 1.8, the picture of a hydrometer is given, and here certain markings are given, and by dipping this into the liquid, whose density is to be measured, we can easily find the relative density. Also, you have studied that lactometer is the device which is used to measure the purity, to check the purity of milk. Now, it is a type of hydrometer. The working of a hydrometer and a lactometer is based on the principle of flotation. This is often asked. That is, what is the principle behind hydrometer, or the principle used to make a lactometer? That is, it is working on the basis of the principle of flotation. Principle of flotation. Don't forget this. That is, it is working on the both the devices are working on the principle of flotation. Now, you can easily make a hydrometer using a straw. You can close one end of the straw and put some sand in it. And for adjusting the weight, that is, we have to put it in water or liquid, and it should stand straight. For that, some sand or soil are taken and it is put inside this straw. And remember that the one other end of the straw is tied or closed using a wax or any other method. then put this in water and where the straw, the surface of the straw strikes the water surface, mark this as 1. That is, relative density of water is 1, taken as 1. How we get it as 1? Because relative density is equal to density of substance by density of water. Then relative density of water will be density of water divided by density of water, that is 1000 by 1000, that is equal to 1. Now certain questions are given here and we have to answer the following questions. What will be, the first question is, what will be the reading when the hydrometer is dipped in water? When the hydrometer is dipped in water, what will be the reading? We are sure that for water, relative density is 1. Therefore, when dipped in pure water, then the reading will be 1. So, here you write the answer as 1. Now, the second question. Suppose a hydrometer is dipped in a liquid of density greater than that of water. Greater than that of water. What is the relation between density and flotation? That is, if the density of the liquid is greater than that of water, the liquid we have taken has density greater than that of water, then it will exert more buoyant force, and it will the liquid surface be above or below the marking of 1? Then surely it will be below the marking of 1, because the marking 1 is when it is put in water, and since the liquid has greater density, the buoyant force will be greater, and hence the hydrometer will be pushed upwards with a strong force, and so the marking on the liquid surface will be below the marking of 1. Now the third question, in which will the hydrometer sink deeper? In liquid, hydrometer will sink deeper. If the hydrometer sinks deeper, that means the buoyancy is less. That means the liquids of lower density. The liquids are of lower density. Now, the fourth question is, why do the markings on the hydrometer increase towards the bottom? Why do the markings on the hydrometer increase towards the bottom? Please look at the picture of the hydrometer. Here the markings are seen to increase towards the bottom. Towards the bottom, on coming downwards, the markings are increasing. Why is it taken so? Because lesser the density of liquid, the hydrometer sinks more. When the density is low, the hydrometer will sink more. Now, lactometer is an instrument used for this purpose. What is the use of lactometer? It is used to find how the quantity of water in milk is there. That is, the quantity of water in milk. Is there water is added in milk? We can find it out by using a lactometer. The lactometer, which is a device to test the purity of milk, is basically a hydrometer. Adulteration of milk, that is, adulteration means mayam kalartal. Adulteration of milk is an offense. It is a criminal offense. We should not do that. Therefore, any adulteration, any type of adulteration in food or any other materials, other substances are considered as an offense. So, you should be careful never to do any adulteration in our life.